Good morning, students, and welcome to another online physical science classroom of St. Michael's Academy. Today, I am going to start a new chapter. It's a very, very interesting chapter. Name of the chapter is Oxidation and Reduction. No need to mug up or no need to learn this chapter, but you have to understand the base of this oxidation and reduction. Then you can explain any reaction on the basis of oxidation and reduction. So let's start this interesting chapter. First, I have to define oxidation. What is oxidation? The chemical process in which oxygen atom combines with an element or a compound, or hydrogen atom is removed from a compound, is generally called oxidation process. So there are three conditions for an oxidation process. Either oxygen atom combines with an element, first one. Second one, oxygen atom combines with a compound, and the third one is hydrogen atom removed from a compound. So there are three reasons are there. If any of the three reasons will happen, then you can say it's an oxidation process. Hope so you have understood this. Now next one, oxidation by combination of oxygen. So you have seen from the definition that either oxidation happens by combination of oxygen or oxidation happens by removal of hydrogen. So first we are taking the first condition, that is oxidation by combination of oxygen. So there are two types, first of all, element plus oxygen. Element plus oxygen. Second one is element plus oxygen containing compound. So let's start with the first one. With an example, I'm giving you the idea of this element plus oxygen. First, see the reaction. Here, zinc, Zn zinc, is an element, and O2 obviously is an oxygen molecule. When they react, zinc oxide will be formed. So here, from zinc to zinc oxide, in your book, arrow given, please read the reaction properly, and please see the reaction, observe the arrows properly, direction of arrows properly. From zinc to zinc oxide happens. That means this is an oxidation process. One more time I am repeating, from zinc to zinc oxide, actually formation of zinc oxide happens over here. That means it is an oxidation process. On burning in oxygen, zinc is oxidized to form white fumes of zinc oxide, which condenses as wool-like solid called philosopher's wool. Always remember, zinc oxide is a wool-like solid. After condensation, it is a wool-like solid, which is called philosopher's wool. And how it is formed? When zinc reacts with oxygen, zinc oxide will be formed. Now let's move to the other examples. Second one is element plus oxygen containing compound. See the examples first. Carbon is an element plus H2SO4, that is sulfuric acid. So sulfuric acid, you can see it is an oxygen containing compound. When they react, carbon dioxide or CO2, sulfur dioxide or SO2, and water or H2O will be formed. So where is exactly oxidation occurs in this reaction? We can say that from carbon to carbon dioxide, here exactly oxidation occurs. How? By combination of oxygen with carbon element. Here it happens by combination of oxygen with zinc element. Hope so you have understood. Now the next one is when carbon reacts with another oxygen containing compound, that is nitric acid, HNO3. So what will be formed? CO2 or carbon dioxide, NO2 or nitrogen dioxide, and water or H2 will be formed. Now here, where oxidation occurs from carbon to carbon dioxide, here also same thing, oxygen combines with an element called carbon to form carbon dioxide. So C2CO2 oxidation occurs. When carbon is warmed with nitric acid or concentrated sulfuric acid, it is oxidized to form carbon dioxide. Hope so you have understood the total theory portion. Now let's move to the diagram portion. By an arrow diagram, I have tried my best to show you what is oxidation and what is reduction. You can see oxidation, compound A loses electrons. Actually, on the basis of electron theory, I have tried my best to show you or to give you the idea about oxidation and reduction. So compound A, this is compound A, loses electrons, and this is oxidation where a compound loses electrons, and this is reduction where compound B or any compound will gain electrons. You can see it is gaining electron and it is loses it lost electrons. Hope so you have understood. B is oxidizing agent and A is reducing agent, just opposite occurs. So A is oxidized and B is reduced. Now the third one, under the heading or title oxidation by combination of oxygen, the third one is compound plus oxygen. See the example, NO plus O2, formation of NO2 occurs. So what is NO? That is nitric oxide, you know. And what is NO2? That is nitrogen dioxide, that also you know. And what is N2O? Hope so you remember, that is nitrous oxide or laughing gas. Now see, colorless gaseous nitric oxide just in contact with oxygen changes to brown gaseous nitrogen dioxide. That means the color of nitrogen dioxide is brown and NO is colorless, or nitric oxide is colorless. Here nitric oxide combines with oxygen, so it is an oxidation process. So oxidation occurs from NO to NO2 because number of oxygen in a compound is increasing. So you have understood. So let's move to the next one, that is oxidation by removal of hydrogen. There are also three types. First one, compound plus oxygen. You can see the example. When ammonia is ignited in oxygen, ignited means you can say burnt. In oxygen, it burns with yellow flame. Hydrogen is removed from ammonia and nitrogen is formed. Hydrogen and oxygen combine together to form water. The removal of hydrogen from ammonia is thus an oxidation process. So you can see the reaction when NH3 or ammonia reacts with oxygen or O2, nitrogen, that is yellow flame, burns with yellow flame, nitrogen gas, N2 and H2 formed. Now here, where actually oxidation occurs from NH3 to N2. See, removal of hydrogen occurs, so this is the oxidation process. Now let's move to the next one. Compound plus oxygen containing compound. Sometimes oxygen contained in a compound removes hydrogen atom of other compound. For example, when hydrochloric acid mixed with manganese dioxide is heated, hydrogen atom from HCl is removed and chlorine is formed. Here HCl is oxidized by MnO2. So you can see the reaction when HCl or hydrochloric acid reacts with manganese dioxide or MnO2, MnCl2, that means manganese chloride plus chlorine and H2O or water will be formed. So here, where oxidation exactly occurs? From HCl to Cl, because removal of hydrogen atom occurs. So from HCl to for the formation of chlorine gas. This is the actual state where oxidation occurs in this reaction. Now the last one, without oxygen. When hydrogen sulfide gas is passed into red color solution of bromine water, the latter is decolorized and yellow sulfur is precipitated. Bromine displaces hydrogen atom of H2S and makes oxidation. H2S is oxidized to sulfur. So you can see the reaction. When H2S or hydrogen sulfide gas reacts with bromine water, formation of sulfur and HBr, hydrobromic acid, or you can say hydrogen bromide, both are same, either hydrobromic acid or hydrogen bromide, like hydrochloric acid or hydrogen chloride HCl. So same here. So here also oxidation occurs. One thing I want to mention over here. Here oxidation occurs from H2S to S. In your book, there is a printing mistake actually, where the arrow is showing from H2S to HBr. It's actually wrong. Please correct this. Correct one will be from H2S to S, sulfur, because removal of hydrogen occurs. Now let's move to the diagram. Same thing that before some time I have told you, that is A and B, two elements. So reduction means gain of electron, you can see. B is reduced, that's why. And A is oxidized, because oxidation means loss of electrons. Hope you have understood this oxidation total examples and definition. And I have given the basic idea of oxidation and reduction also by diagram. So hope so. It is clear to you. If you have any type of doubt, please jot it down and ask me in my Zoom class. So thank you, students, and have a nice day.